स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 3 फ्रॉम फुटप्रिंट्स विदाउट फीट एंड द थर्ड चैप्टर इज द मिडनाइट विजिटर। द मेन कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर आर ऑसिबिल फाउलर एंड मैक्स। स्टूडेंट्स ऑसिबिल इज द मेन कैरेक्टर ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। ही इज ए स्पाई एंड सीक्रेट एजेंट एंड अनदर कैरेक्टर फाउलर। फाउलर इज ए राइटर हु वॉन्ट्स टू राइट सम राइटिंग्स रिलेटेड टू स्पाइज और सम डिटेक्टिव यार्न एंड मैक्स। मैक्स इज अनदर सीक्रेट एजेंट। नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट द चैप्टर। नाउ सी फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट। पॉसिबल अ सीक्रेट एजेंट इज एक्सपेक्टिंग टू गेट ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिपोर्ट। एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट ऑसिबिल इज ए सीक्रेट एजेंट एंड स्पाई एंड ही इज एक्सपेक्टिंग टू गेट ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पेपर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिपोर्ट रिगार्डिंग द मिसाइल्स एंड अनदर सीक्रेट एजेंट मैक्स threatens him with a pistol demanding the report. Another secret agent Max works just like a villain and he works for another group and he threatens him with a pistol, demands the report. So let us know, does Ossible outwit him? Ossible gives him the report or he very cleverly or tactfully doesn't give it? So students, now come to further. Ossible did not fit any description of a secret agent Fowler had ever read. Fowler, who is a writer, he went to meet Ossible, and when he met him, he found that on the basis of physical appearance, Ossible did not fit. He did not look like a secret agent. Following him down the musty corridor of the gloomy French hotel where Ossible had a room, Fowler went to him, met him, and he started going after him in a room where he lived. Ossible lived on the 6th and top floor of a French hotel. Fowler felt let down. It was a small room on the 6th and top floor and scarcely a setting for a romantic adventure. As I have already told you that Ossible had a small room on the 6th and top floor of a French hotel, and we can say that it was also not fit for a kind of any romantic adventure. Ossible was, for one thing, fat, very fat. The author tells us about the appearance of Ossible. As far as Fowler was concerned, कि ऑसवेल डिड नॉट फिट एनी डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ ए सीक्रेट एजेंट बिकॉज ही वॉज वेरी फैट, वेरी फैट. एज वी नो दैट सीक्रेट एजेंट्स आर क्वाइट एक्टिव, डायनामिक, लीन एंड थिन. बट ऑसवेल वॉज वेरी फैट. एंड देन देयर वॉज हिज एक्सेंट, वे ऑफ स्पीकिंग, वे ऑफ प्रोनाउंसिएशन. दो ही स्पोक फ्रेंच एंड जर्मन पासिवली, ऑल्दो ही न्यू वेल हाउ टू स्पीक फ्रेंच एंड जर्मन, तो ही हैड नेवर ऑल टूगेदर लॉस द अमेरिकन एक्सेंट. वाइल स्पीकिंग फ्रेंच एंड जर्मन ही ऑलवेज हैड अमेरिकन एक्सेंट. ही हैड ब्राउट टू पेरिस फ्रॉम बॉस्टन 20 years ago. Although he belonged, basically he belonged to America, but he was living in a French hotel and he knew well how to speak French and German, both. He came from Boston 20 years ago. And when Fowler met Ausubel, they start a kind of conversation. They start talking to each other. "You are disappointed," Ausubel said wheezily over his shoulder. Taking heavy breath, Ausubel said to Fowler, "You are disappointed. Definitely you are not feeling well. You were told that I was a secret agent, a spy dealing in espionage and danger." Ausubel told Fowler that he was told that Ausubel was a secret agent, he was a spy and dealing in espionage. Espionage stands for spying and danger. "You wish to meet me because you are a writer, young and romantic." And as we know that Fowler was a writer, and he met Ausubel because he wanted to write some writing related to a spy or some detective yarn. "You envisioned mysterious figures in the night, the crack of pistols, drugs and the wine." Meaning thereby, when Ausubel came to know what the purpose Fowler had, definitely he said to him that he was thinking about those ideas that were related to a spy or some detective. "Instead, you have spent a dull evening in a French music hall with a sloppy fat man, who instead of having messages slipped into his hand by dark-eyed beauties, get only a project telephone call, making an appointment in his room." Again, he was telling Fowler that perhaps he spent a very dull evening in a French music hall, as he wanted to meet him, and he wanted to meet him because of having some ideas of spying he had spent a lot time to meet him. "You have been bored," and perhaps he had been bored. The fat man chuckled to himself as he unlocked the door of his room and stood aside to let his frustrated guest enter. Ausubel was simply saying all these things to Fowler, and saying all these things he started laughing silently, chuckled to himself. And in the same way, he unlocked the door of his room. As we know that his room was on the 6th and top floor of the French hotel, and he unlocked his door, stood aside. He stood on one side to let Fowler enter into his room. "You are disillusioned," Osbel told him. Osbel again told him that really he was disillusioned. "But take cheer, my young friend." But he altogether assured him and asked him to take cheer. "Presently you will see a paper, a quite important paper for which several men and women have risked their lives. Come to me." And Osbel told Fowler that definitely he will show him a very important paper. He will show him a very important report regarding the missiles for which several men and women have risked their lives, because that was a very important report, and the lives of several men and women were really on risk, in danger. And he even told Fowler that someday soon that paper may well affect the course of history. And he also told Fowler that really someday that report will change the course of history. In that thought is drama, is there not? As he spoke, Osbel closed the door behind him. As he was speaking all these things, the Osbel closed the door behind him. Osbel closed the door of his room behind him. Then he switched on the light. When both Osbel and Fowler were inside the room, he switched on the light. Now there was light in the room. And as the light came on, and when he switched on the light, when there was ample light in the room, Fowler had his first authentic thrill of the day. Fowler was very much thrilled, for halfway across the room, a small automatic pistol in his hand stood a man. Fowler was very much thrilled, and we can say he was frightened when he saw that a man was standing there in the room having a small automatic pistol in his hand. Osbel blinked a few minutes. Osbel also blinked his eyelids. Students, I have already told you that another character is Max, and Max is another secret agent. He is working for another group. And when Osbel opened the door of his room, Max was there. Max was in the room having automatic pistol in his hand. "Max," he wheezed. When Osbel saw Max, he took a heavy breath and started asking, "Max, you gave me quite a start. You really startled me. I thought you were in Berlin. What are you doing here in my room? I thought that you were in Berlin. He might be in Berlin. And again Oswell asked him what he was doing there in his room. Max was slender, a little less than tall, with features that suggested slightly the crafty, pointed countenance of a fox. There was about him, aside from the gun, nothing especially menacing. In these lines, the author describes the appearance of Max. He was lean and thin, and not a taller man, with features that suggested slightly the crafty. Crafty stands for cunning. He was looking quite cunning, pointed countenance of a fox, and his countenance stands for the face, and his face was just looking like a fox. Although he did not have anything else, there was about him, aside from the gun, nothing especially menacing. Menace stands for danger. The report, he murmured, the report that is being brought to you tonight concerning some new missiles. Now students, as I have already told you that Max was there having a pistol in his hand, as we also see in the picture that is given here in the text. He at once started demanding the report that is being brought to you tonight concerning some new missiles. And he demands the report. He at once threatened Oswell, asking him to give the report to him. He threatened him to hand him over the report that was being brought to him tonight, and this report was concerning some new missiles. He further added, I thought I would take it from you. It will be safer in my hands than in yours. And Max simply told Oswell to give the report, and he as well threatened him also. Now we shall see that very tactfully Oswell planned. Oswell moved to an armchair and sat down heavily. Oswell bent towards the armchair and sat down heavily. And he said to Max, I am going to raise the devil with the management this time, and you can bet on it. He started making some planning. He started making a kind of strategy against it, and said to Max that he many times complained the hotel management about the thing that is given ahead. This is the second time in a month that somebody has got into my room through that nuisance of a balcony. He said that he had already complained the hotel management that this was the second time that someone entered into his room through the balcony. As we can say that there is a window in his room, and he said that outside of the window there was a balcony. Fowler's eyes went to the single window of the room. Fowler saw that there was only a single window in his room. It was an ordinary window against which now the night was pressing blackly. Only one window was there, and it was the ordinary window. Okay, students, so that's all for today. We shall continue it tomorrow. Thank you.